every January people tend to make resolutions, and before it is March, people start going back to their old ways. How do I look today? How am I looking? Hello, you're welcome back to June TV. How was your holidays? Well, mine was good. I hope yours was good as well. It's January. Yes, January is a month of resolutions. Have you made yours? Well, I've made mine. So today I want to quickly tell us something. You know, every January, some of us make resolutions. Some people don't believe in resolutions. But if you do, don't forget to include your relationship in your resolution. Meanwhile, if you just seen this video for the first time, this is June TV, where I discuss everything human affairs, basically relationship talks. Yes, so today I want to tell us a little thing that most of us always ignore, that are not always good for our relationships. For instance, we have friends. Okay, we have a lot of friends, acquaintances, lovers, family members, and those we can't afford not to tell everything. I mean, all those little gisting around. You know, if you have all these friends and families that you tell a lot of things about your relationship, I think it's about time you stop doing that. So I'm just going to give you 5 things you shouldn't spill out in the open about your relationships, because it might in one way or the other be destroying your relationship without you knowing. In fact, it does destroy relationship without you knowing. The first one is that you should never discuss the details of your sex life to anybody. Yes, all those best friends, all those, you know, close pals, all those much gisting. Don't tell them. Don't tell anybody how good it is, how bad it is, the often time you had sex, the last time you had sex, or his sexual fantasies and all of that, or her sexual fantasies and all of that. Or if she's not good, talk to her. If he's not good, talk to him. If you have an issue in your marriage or relationship, sexual life, talk to your partner. If worse goes to worse, you can talk to a therapist who could help you figure out the issues and not go talking to girlfriends. You know why? Because if you have bad girlfriends, they will look for a way to come sleep with your man or with your girl if you have bad boyfriends. But if you have good girlfriends, in the other way around, they might try to advise you wrongly. Since he's not good, what are you doing with him? Leave him. All those things are not what you need this year, okay? You need steady relationships that could lead you somewhere positive. So stop spilling that little details about your sex life. Keep your mouth shut. Okay, that's number one. Number two, if he's not good with giving you gifts, okay, don't go bad mouthing him around your friends. Yes, he gave you a wrong gift, a bad gift, and so what? Tell him thank you. What's more important is that he thought about you before he gave you the gift. If he didn't think about you, he wouldn't remember to buy you something. But giving you the gift means that he thought about you, so that is why he gave you the gift. So, zip your mouth and say thank you, even if you like or don't like it. That's number two. Number three, okay, whatever your partner tells you in confidence, please don't ever spill it, okay, because confidence lost in relationship is very difficult to get back. And confidence is very key to relationships. And if your trust in relationship is broken because you went about saying things he told you or she told you in confidence, it will be difficult for you to build back that trust again. So zip your mouth, whatever he tells you in confidence, let it remain with you and only you. Okay, so the fourth one, if your in-law by chance offends you, alright, because we are humans and people offend us once in a while. Yeah, if your in-law by chance offends you, don't go gossiping about it with your girlfriend or with your guys. Because if your partner or your in-law gets to know about that by chance or by anything, they are going to be resentful and defensive, which is not what you want Okay, you want your relationship with everybody to be cordial, right? Good, so if they offend you, why not just go talk to your partner about that? Tell him your in-law has offended you, and he has a way, or he might, or she might have a way of making that stuff, you know, resolving it for you instead of going talking about it and creating unnecessary tension in the home. Okay, so talk about that. The last one, the fifth one, is that if, for instance, okay, you fight all the time. Yeah, of course, relationships are meant to have quarrels and all of that. But don't go talking about your latest fight, because your fights are not for public consumption. Yes, you heard me. They're not for public consumption. Couples fight and what? By the time you go start telling people that you fought the last time, what caused the fight, and all of that, they will not allow you and your partner to learn how to deal with your fights by yourself. Okay, for instance, now I come telling you about the fight I had last with my guy, and you didn't hear he's from his own path, and then you start judging him from your distance, saying all sort of things and corrupting my mind. Just like when he comes to you telling you about the fight we had, you didn't hear from me, but you've heard from him, and you judge from one side. In fact, who even made you a judge? So, you see, when you have fight with your partner, what you should do is sit her down, resolve your fight without having to call the third party. Because when you call the third party to your relationship, seriously, you're not doing your relationship any good. Okay? So, I'm giving you five little things you shouldn't spill. Yes, they are very little, but they could go a long way in damaging a relationship. And this year, honestly, that's not what you want, right? We want a good relationship, we want to start on a good note, we want to end this year on a good note, relationship-wise. Okay, so thank you so much for watching my video today. I hope you like it. I hope you've learned something. Please, if you want to see more of my works and my videos, just click on that subscribe button you can see on your screen, and make sure you click on that little bell so that you can have notifications each time I make my uploads. Yes, my videos are uploaded every Friday, so watch out for it. And please, if you love this video, please forward it to others, okay? Make sure everybody on your contacts gets it. And I will see you again next week. And until then, I love you, okay? So stay out of trouble and